upside at the expense of others. Which brings us to the largest fragilizer of society and greatest generator of crises, absence of skin in the game. Some become anti-fragile at the expense of others by getting the upside or gains from volatility, variations, and disorder, and exposing others to the downside risks of losses or harm. And such anti-fragility at the cost of fragility of others is hidden. Given the blindness to anti-fragility by the Soviet Harvard intellectual circles, this asymmetry is rarely identified and so far never taught. Further, as we discovered during the financial crisis that started in 2008, these blow-up risks to others are easily concealed owing to the growing complexity of modern institutions and political affairs. While in the past, people of rank or status were those and only those who took risks, who had the downside for their actions, and heroes were those who did so for the sake of others, today the exact reverse is taking place. We are witnessing the rise of a new class of inverse heroes, that is, bureaucrats, bankers, Davos-attending members of the IAND, International Association of Name Droppers, and academics with too much power and no real downside and or accountability. They game the system while citizens pay the price. At no point in history have so many non-risk takers, that is, those with no personal exposure, exerted so much control. The chief ethical rule is the following: thou shalt not have anti-fragility at the expense of the fragility of others.